I'll request Professor PVM Rao on education.
Okay, good afternoon. We just crossed the noon. Okay. So unlike five Pandavas, we were seven. I forgot to capture, so I can call as Satya Pe Sata. So I think there are some of the common observations which came during last 2 days were captured. So I thought first I'll put some observations and then action items. So one of the observations which came is that there's not enough knowledge creation activities or courses which probably give opportunity for students to engage in knowledge creation and subjects like inclusive manufacturing in our institutes and universities. So that's a need which need to be filled. And also there are a lot of examples of good prototypes which are coming out. In some cases it have reached like one user or two users. But I think the moment you try to take them to, let's say, 10,000 or 500,000, you need to completely have a completely a different design and manufacturing philosophy for that, which is actually not happening. In other words, instead of one person, if I want to take it to, let's say, 500,000, how do I take care of maintenance, warranty? You don't bother about those aspects, kind of a thing. Other thing which was also there is that why many of the innovations are actually not going ahead beyond, let's say, a very limited prototyping experience is also that we are not addressing all the life cycle issues, which, as I mentioned. And this is another one where we looked at many of the SMEs and startups and nonprofits do not have a seamless entry into educational institutes. Still, there is a lot of gap. Most of them, they mentioned the kind of problems they face in interacting with educational institutes. It's at all levels, physical resources like equipment, machines, human resources like student, and intellectual resources like faculty and others. And it's also seen that there is a large part of inclusive manufacturing happens in unorganized sector, and there is a clear gap between how to engage with, let's say, people in informal sector with educational institutes. I think we haven't still found a good model for that. That's something which is a gap. And a couple of other observations is there are very limited opportunities for people of informal sector to be benefited by what happens in educational institutes, which is there. And also, it was also pointed out by some of our members that our education system is more of which actually looks at, follows most of the Western model rather than looking at more futuristic, future requirements of the country. These were some of the clear observations which came up. And the action items were very crisp. First thing which was there is, is it possible to have a one credit course on social immersion for all students very early in the programs? Whether it's engineering or social sciences, design or management, this could be something which is a first introduction for people to understand how the world works. Because a lot of technology teaches how the things work, but I think it's extremely important to know how the world works. And second aspect is either mandatory or elective, where we did not have a consensus, is to have a course on inclusive innovation or inclusive manufacturing, which is basically a team-based and goal-oriented in our courses as a part of the programs. Is it possible to create? This should be one of the recommendations. Depending on the institutes, it can be mandatory or elective. How it happens could be one of them. When we say goal-oriented, again, it could be you probably end up with just a solution. In some case, look-alike, work-alike prototypes. In some cases, it could be functional prototypes. So that is also left little loose, how people would like to plan. And then some people said there should be backup courses to take these things ahead, kind of a thing. It should be a multi-semester courses and kind of thing. The third is, in case if you run a course on, let's say, inclusive manufacturing or inclusive innovation, and let's say if there are 20 teams which are working, and let's say there are 5 bright ideas which have potential to reach market, society, or industry. How do you provide, how do you keep these projects alive? By providing a small seed funding to faculty student team to take it ahead. How do we create such opportunities within educational institutes was discussed. And also, this is very important. The moment we say an inclusive manufacturing, the connection with the outside world is an extremely important. Presently, in our educational systems, we don't have a good frameworks to interact with outside world. Even like there are cases, like in one of the cases, it was mentioned that teacher wanted to take a group of students to, let's say, an immersion to a rural area, and principal told ki there are no such budget for such things. There are no, there's no provision in our budget for such activities. So the kind of frameworks which you need to create, I think it's a bi-directional. How do you bring the people who are in inclusive innovation on the field into the campus? And second thing is, how do you take students to immerse in the real world to actually identify the need and solutions and co-create is an extremely important, and we need to find more such mechanisms to do that. Similarly, it was felt that there are a lot of engineering colleges and other colleges do wonderful projects, which are probably few hundred thousand projects or few hundreds of thousands of projects which comes. Is it possible to identify a few potential of them and give them an additional year of fellowship to pursue those ideas, to basically see that there is a very high possibility that the benefits actually reach either market, industry, or society? Can we create such fellowships was one. And having very successful, I think one of the good thing which happened in last 2 days is that we have seen a lot of good case studies. Is it possible to prepare a good case studies and use them as a curricula if you are offering such courses was another idea which came. And a lot of inclusive manufacturing which happens in institutes, particularly students, require a lot of mentorship, which institute themselves cannot provide. So is it possible to have a mentor-mentee cloud network where if I have a problem, when I don't have answers coming from, let's say, within my institute, can I just flag it off because I have a mentor network which is available, was one of the models suggested. And this was a more of them. If some institutes would like to have a major program, let's say a master's program in inclusive manufacturing or this thing, then there should be a provision. Well, that's a welcome idea. But any such program should not be basically put as a part of one entity, because it requires a multiple inputs of social sciences, engineering, management, arts and design, etc. So it has to be truly a multidisciplinary program, if at all such a program is planned by some of the institutes, universities. The last page is that, is it possible to create inclusive manufacturing internships and externships? Internship for students and externship for faculty. I think UK model is a very good of having externship for faculty to spend outside at least 2 weeks, which we heard earlier was one of the good ideas. And how do we put like guest and adjunct faculty position to successful innovators from various parts to come to the campus was another idea. Then this was another very interesting suggestion which came is ki in DST we have a lot of funding schemes. So is it possible to create another vertical which can be under inclusive innovation or manufacturing at 3 different stages, idea to POC, early transition, and pilot. And they require different type of work and different type of teams and different type of funding levels. So this is another action item which was suggested. One of the strong suggestion was that after this particular thing, do we have a portal on inclusive manufacturing where people can contribute as well as access to this? And also mention was made of special incubator in inclusive manufacturing. Like we have a special incubators in healthcare. We have like 16 of those now in the country. So is there anything like in inclusive manufacturing which is happening? And this was very important that the faculty who engage in such activities generally do not get I think these do not feature in the metrics of evaluation. For example, we have good metrics for knowledge creation in terms of research, publications, citations, impact factors, etc. We also kind of struggle to have evaluation metrics for teaching, which is not easy. But is it possible to have evaluation metrics for innovation and knowledge application activities was another one. And this was, I think here it was only a suggestion, there was no crisp as to what should be the initiative for skill building and vocational training for non-formal sectors, and what is the role of educational institutes in this was also discussed. And last slide is, since we also have an international community, it was thought key what could be possible collaboration models. So I think there are possible where students, faculty, and industry on either side, and we can have multiple models, student-student, student-faculty, student-SME, SME-SME. I don't know what is the shape it can take, but these are all possibilities. Thank you.